Let us so let us start the class. In the previous class we have discussed example on design of Moore and Mille machines. Today we'll see how we can convert a Mille machine to an equivalent Moore machine, or a Moore machine to an equivalent Mille machine. So we'll see the conversion. We'll consider the same example that we have designed for a Mille machine in the previous class, that is addition of two binary numbers. So first, this is a given Mille machine for addition of two binary numbers, which is having two states, as a carry state and a no carry state, and we have seen how we designed this machine in the previous class itself. Now first, for before conversion, what we'll do, we'll convert this Mille machine to transition table form, in the diagram, transition diagram to transition table form. So we have converted it in this particular way. So the input is a combination of bit 0 and 0 for the first and second number, 1 1 0 1 and 1 0, right? And the next state as well as the output related to the transition is shown in the table. So this is the current state column, and in the next state column we have the next state as well as output for the particular input, right? So from this transition diagram we have obtained this transition table, which says that from Q0, if the input is 00, the next state is Q0 and the output which is produced is 0. Similarly, from Q0, if the input is 11, the transition is to state Q1 and the output which is produced is 0. That is what we have mentioned over here, Q0 on input 11, the next state is Q1 and the output produced is 0. Similarly, for Q0 on 01, the next state is Q0 and the output is 1. And for Q0 on 10, the next state is Q0 and the output is 1. In the same way, we have added the transition for state Q1 in this transition table, right? Now, for converting this Mille machine to an equivalent Moore machine, we need to first check for the next state column and the respective output related to a particular state, right? Like suppose we are considering Q0 at the start, what we'll do, we'll see what are the existence of Q0 in the next state column and what are the related output. Like we can see that Q0 appears here, here, here and here in the next state column. These are the four places where Q0 appears, and you can also see that the output for Q0s are 0 and 1, right? Both outputs are there. Here you have Q0 with 0 output, here you have Q0 with 1 output, here Q0 is having 1 output, and here also Q0 is having 1 output. So the possibility of output were 0 and 1, and Q0 have both the possibilities of output, right? So Q0 can have output 0 as well as Q0 can have an output 1, right? So for converting Mille to Moore, we'll make an equivalent table. Now the difference in the table of a Mille machine and Moore machine is that for a particular state, we have a single output in case of Moore machine, whereas in case of Mille machine, we have multiple output for a particular state. It was dependent on the transition, right? So for Q0, we have four different outputs, right? You can see that based on the input, right? Whereas in case of Moore machine, we'll have a single output column, right? So for a particular state, we'll have a fixed output. So here we can see that Q0 is having two different types of output, as 0 and 1. So in the equivalent Moore machine, we will create two states for this Q0. For one state, we will make equivalent two states. One state will be representing an output 0, whereas the other Q0 state will represent an output 1. So we will directly produce output 0 and 1 for state Q0 and the other Q0. And we'll put that output in the output column of the transition table, right? So Q0 was having two different outputs, so we'll produce two new states as Q00 and Q01. Q00 will be the state that will produce an output 0, whereas Q01 will be the state that will produce an output 1, right? Now similarly, we look for the state Q1, and you can observe that the appearance of Q1 in the next state has again two outputs, as 0 and 1. So Q1 can have an output 0 as well as Q1 can have an output 1, right? So again, we need to form two new states in the equivalent Moore machine for state Q1, right? So we make two new state as Q10 and Q11. Q10 will be the state that will produce an output 0, whereas Q11 will be the state that will produce an output 1. Now we have made four states and the respective output for them. Now we need to add transition in the Moore table, right? A Moore transition table. So for that we'll again look into the Miele machine table. So Q00 on input 00 will go to which state? We need to find this. So for this we'll go to the equivalent Miele machine, and in Q0, in case of Miele machine, Q0 on input 00 goes to state Q0 itself. But now when we want to convert it to Moore machine, we need to check the output also. So there is a transition to Q0, but which part of Q0 it is transiting? It is transiting to the part of Q0 wherein the output is generated as 0. So in the equivalent Moore machine, from Q00, if the input is 00, we should transit to the state of Q0 that is producing an output 0, right? So we have two states of Q0 as Q00 and Q01. And Q00 is the state which is having an output 0. So here we'll add a transition as Q00 on 00 goes to the next state as Q00, which is producing an output 0, right? Similarly, for Q0 on input 11, it goes to a state Q1 and produces an output 0. And the output 0 for Q1 is represented by the state Q10. So from Q00, if the input is 11, in the equivalent Moore machine, we'll make a transition to state Q10. Similarly, from Q0 on 01, it goes to Q0 and produces an output 1. And the equivalent state which is producing an output 1 for Q0 in the equivalent Moore machine is state Q01. So from Q00 on input 01, we'll go to a state of Q0 that produces an output 1. And this state is nothing but Q01. So we add a transition as Q01 from Q00 on input 01. The last transition from Q00 is on input 10, and it goes to a state Q0 with output 1, and that is represented by Q01 in the equivalent Moore machine. So we add a transition from Q00 on input 10 to state Q01. Right. So now this Q00, whatever is the next state, it will always produce an output 0. Right. Similarly, we need to add a transition for the state Q01. Now this, the equivalent state for this is Q0 only, the present state in our equivalent Miele, given Miele machine. So the transition will be same as the previous one. So you can see that Q01, so Q0 on 00 goes to Q0 with output 0. So we'll go to Q00 itself, right? So the same output as that of Q00 will be added for Q01, right? You can check, you will get the same output. Similarly, now we need to compute the output for state Q10, and for which we need to refer the Q1 state of the Miele machine. Okay, so Q1 on 00 goes to a state Q0 with output 1, and this is represented by the state Q01 in our Moore machine, right? So Q10 on input 00 goes to Q01. Similarly, Q1 on 11 in the Miele machine goes to Q1 with output 1, which is represented by the state Q11 in the equivalent Moore machine. So we add a transition Q11, right? Then from Q10 on input 01, we go to a state Q10, and this is represented by Q10 itself. So there will be a self transition over here. So Q10 on 01 goes to Q10, and Q10 on 10, so we look for Q1 on 10, it goes to state Q1 with output 0, which is represented by Q10 in our equivalent Moore machine. So we add a transition from Q10 on 10 to Q10, and the output which is produced for Q10 is 0 for all the transitions. Similar rules will be added for Q11, and we copy those rules directly, and the output which will be produced at this level will be 1. That is, whenever there is Q11 state, the state will produce an output 1. Whenever the automata is in a state Q10, it will produce an output 0. Whenever the automata is in Q10, it would produce an output 1. If it is in Q00, it will produce an output 0. Right. So we have obtained this transition table or the Moore machine, which is equivalent to the given Mille machine, right? You can convert this transition table to a transition diagram form, right? So this is the equivalent Moore machine. I hope this is clear to you. Kindly give a feedback. If you have understood this, just type Y in the chat box. If there is any difficulty, you can unmute and